हेलो, वेलकम बैक डियर स्टूडेंट्स। आज हम जिस कंसेप्ट के बारे में सीखने जा रहे हैं, बेसिकली वो है सेशन। सेशन इज़ वेरी वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट कंसेप्ट व्हाइल यू आर डिजाइनिंग एनी वेबसाइट। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, लेट्स ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज सेशन बेसिकली। सो सेशन इज नथिंग बट अ सिंपल थिंग। Let's say you are opening any website, let's say sbi.com. You are log into the SBI website and then you do something, some transaction or something like that, and then you log out. So basically this period, starting some action, performing that action and completing that action, this particular period is nothing but a session. Okay. In simple computer terminology, or in, let's say you are log into your PC, you do something and you shut down your PC. Basically, your operating system is powerful enough to maintain each and everything that you have performed after login, or whatever the action that you have taken is just logged by the operating system, so that later on they can audit on that, or admin can audit on that what you have done after the login. But when you are logged into some websites or servers are not that much powerful, or let's say they are not maintaining your states, means what you are doing, how you are doing and something like that. So there is something needed to monitor or to store some information regarding each client which are visiting your websites. So that particular stuffs which are performed by the client, it must be stored at the server side. So session is the answer for that. Whichever the action that client performs after visiting the website, that each and everything you can maintain that state of that user is because of this session. So let's compare the session with the cookie. Yes, what is session basically? Session is user's information stored by the server itself at server side in form of variable. Okay, let's make it again. Session is a period in which a user performs at an action, and whatever the information that is stored regarding that user is stored at server side and in form of variables, and it stored by the server itself. Okay, so how server gonna store that variables? For that, three functions are basically used. First is session underscore start. Function is used to start the session. Session underscore destroy is used to destroy the session. And third one, session underscore unset the all the variable of session. Okay, these three are the main function, and the most important things that you should remember is dollar underscore session super global is used to store user information in form of variable, and where you supposed to pass the variable over here. Clear? Whichever you type inside the square bracket in single quotation or double quotation is nothing but a value of a session, and it's stored at server side. Okay, let's get back to the programming side so that you can clear that idea. Okay, what I have done in this particular session 1.php file, I have prepared one form, kind of a login form basically. Inside that I use one text box in which I can store username, and second is password, so that user can type a password, and then submit button so that we can transfer the data to some file, let's say session2.php. So while clicking on this login button, where we moves? Session.php. Before going into the much detail, let me execute this stuff for you so that you can have a clear idea. Then we can go for the explanation part. Let's say I have entered my name, let's say Ankit, and I have entered some password and login from session 1. Where I moves? I move to session3.php. Over here, when message is displayed that username is Ankit, which I have passed, and I have one hyperlink named logout. When I click on the logout, it will unset this variable and destroy the session. Okay, but before that, let me copy this and paste into the new tab. Okay, still see the session is going on, that is why we have displayed, or we are able to get that my name already, because session is continued. When I click on the logout here, basically what happened, this error is come. Actually, this is my user defined message that I have displayed. Error comes or notice come because we have destroyed the session, because see, we are not able to display name over here. Why? Because this variable called name is unset. Okay, I have unset and destroyed the session, that is why I'm not able to display the name. Let's try to refresh this page, session3.php. see, when I refresh this particular session3.php, I'm not able to get my name back over here, which is I have got previously, because session is destroyed. And see, the index uname is undefined. So this is the beauty of the session. And this is why when you are logged into the Gmail and you open new tab and type gmail.com, you can redirect to your login as well. This is the answer. Okay. And when you log out in one tab, you are logged out from each and every tab of Gmail. Yes, this is the answer. I hope so you are getting the concept. Let's see how it works. So what happened, when I click on submit button name login, I move to the session2.php. Okay, so this is the session2.php. Remember, this is very, very important that before HTML tag, you must start this session_start. Otherwise, you won't be able to access these variables. Because wherever you are accessing this variable, because of these things only, because we are starting the session, that is why. So what I have done in session2.php, whichever the username that I got, I just stored into this session variable called uname. So this uname is stored at server side, and due to this session_start, we get that variable easily in any page. And after storing the value, we just redirected this page to session3.php over here, right? So let's see the logic of session3.php. Again, as I have told you, you must start the session_start at very first. Then just I am displaying that username using $session_super global. Yes. And here I put the logout hyperlink. When I click on this logout, where I moves? In this page, logout.php. See, I have displayed that thing. Yes, error. This is my message, user defined message. And then I have unset and destroy the session. And because of this, I am not able to get that variable name over here, because we have destroyed that. So we have tested it successfully. I hope so you are getting the concept of session. Clear? Thanks for watching the video. If you have any query, please comment. I will happy to solve. And if you like the video, please subscribe our college channel and do like the videos as well. Thank you so much.